Hello, I'm going to show you the blood loop and then the twisted boom blood loop. I really like these knots for making up traces. I use them on my wrecking rig. You see these? They just make like a standoff hook length and the end in a loop. So they're good for taking hooks on and off, because all you'll do is you just hook off and then to put the new one back on again, all you do is just take the loop, push it through, put the hook through the loop and pull it down. That's why I like these loops, and it's called the blood loop. I'll show you how to tighten. Now I'm going to show you in a 100-pound line. All you do is you create a big loop like that. You then take part of it and go twist over itself. So all I'm doing is I'm twisting them. See, I've created an eye and I twist it. So I've done that 5 times. You then take the middle of this loop and push it through that little eye. Like that. Then all you do is you wet the knot with saliva. It's important to wet it with saliva so that it doesn't burn the knot when you pull it tight. And just go. There, look. It's important to pull it down evenly so that the knot is even. But there you can see it's made a standoff hook length. These are perfect for putting hooks on, because all you'll do, you just fold the line over itself, take your eye, put the loop through the eye, put the hook through the loop, and there you go. Like that. That's just a simple blood loop. I will show you again. You just need to make a loop like that. Then you take one part of it and twist it over the other. And all you do is you take them two and you keep twisting them. All they're doing is going over each other until it looks like that. You then take this piece and put it through that eye. So your knot will look like that. Then you wet it with saliva and then you pull the two sides apart, which tightens the knot down, and you pull this loop away in this direction. So you pull the loop like that and you pull the sides like that. Watch. There, look. See how neat and even it is? That's very strong. Now, it's a knot. This is in a 100-pound line. This is doubled over, so now this is 200-pound strength. This is good for things like conger and ling, because not only have they got sharp teeth, so it'll take them twice as long to work through this, but when you hook them deep, it's sometimes easier to pull it out through the gill, and then they're easier to slip a hook off. Because to get the hook on, all you do is you just push the loop through, like that. To take the hook off again, all you'll do is just go like this, take the hook out of the loop. That is just a standard blood loop. What I'm going to show you now is a twisted boom blood loop. All that does is it helps it stand off more. See how this loop already stands off proud? Well, a twisted boom blood loop stands off even better. If you're using lighter line, it can sometimes get quite limp and the hooks will end up coming towards the main rig body. You take your length of line And then all you do is you twist it, you spin it in your fingers. Now, with my fingers, I'm going this way with one hand and I'm going this way with the other, like that. Once you've got a few good twists in it, as soon as you push the line together, it wants to kink look. So if you start it in the middle, see how it's spun together there? And as soon as you start twisting, there, you see how you've made a section here, which is twisted round itself. Then all you do, once you've got the hook length that you want, now this is probably 8 to 10 inches. Now you tie a blood loop like you did before. So you make a little loop and you just take part of it and go over the other part, look, like that. Right, now that you have your knot like that and this eye, you take this piece and put it through that eye. When you do this, you need to make sure that all of these little twists are through that eye before you pull it down tight. Then you wet it, and then you pull your sides apart, and you boom up. Watch. Like this. There again, look. A very neat knot. And this is now a twisted boom. So when you put your hook on, like this, it's a strong standoff hook length. So that's the difference. I'll show you, I'll compare the two. That is just a normal blood loop. And that is a twisted boom blood loop. See how it's twisted round itself? Whereas that one is just a loop. Both of these are good. I prefer these sometimes when I'm using lighter line because they stand off better. You can see how it's got a bit more memory in it for standing off. Whereas this one, as soon as you put a hook on there, it can get quite limp. But that is the blood loop there and the twisted boom blood loop. If the line that you are using is too thick, once doubled over like this to go through the eye of a hook, what you can do there is you simply snip off the bottom one of these like that, and this becomes your hook length. So you just pass your hook through like that and tie it on. So I'll use a uni knot here. 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go, just like that. That is the blood loop. Perfect for making rigs like homemade feather rigs or two hook flappers, one hook flappers, anything where you want a couple of hook lengths. And the beauty about rigs like this is there are no components. So when you're fishing in a wreck or in the snaggy ground and you lose this, literally all you've lost is a little bit of line and two hooks. There you go.